My name is Chelsea Bahney. I'm an assistant adjunct professor here at UCSF, and we are part of the Orthopedic Trauma Institute, which is located at the San Francisco General Hospital. What I'm interested in doing is using stem cells and studying how stem cells both contribute to healing during bone regeneration or bone healing, like if you break your leg, or if you damage your cartilage and diseases like osteoarthritis. So we're interested in understanding how the stem cell contributes to healing in those processes and then developing new therapies that utilize stem cells to repair the defect, so if it's a bone defect or a cartilage defect.
Of fractures?
So I grew up in Colorado, and my dad is a ophthalmologist, so he's an eye surgeon, and then my mom is a nurse. And so I've always been involved in medicine. Part of what got me interested in the field I'm in right now is that I was an athlete, and all through high school and in college I was a ski racer. And between high school injuries and college injuries, I've broken, I don't know, maybe 20 bones, had two knee surgeries, one shoulder surgery, and so I was really interested in this idea of orthopedic surgery, since I'd had so many, and specifically how I could improve outcomes. And my mom said, you're not going to be able to walk by the time you're 40, so I really wanted to make sure that I could walk by the time I was 40. A typical day for me, they're very cyclical, and it depends a little bit on what phase I'm in, and I sort of like that variety. So if I'm in a research heavy phase, I'll be doing anything from working in the lab. I do a lot of cell culture, and so we'll be culturing mesenchymal stem cells and putting them into different biomaterial scaffolds. So in the tissue culture hood, we're trying to grow new pieces of cartilage and bone from stem cells. And then the other thing we work on is trying to use models of fracture repair. And so we will be looking at how a fracture heals and trying to look at things that might delay a fracture, things that might speed up a fracture. And so we're studying the fracture histologically, which means kind of at a microscopic level to understand how the different cells contribute to the fracture repair. And if we're trying to invent, say, a novel therapy, is it working? Are we making things heal faster or slower? So we do a number of histological techniques to quantify how fast something's healing. And so we are interested in kind of any orthopedic related disease, from breaking your leg to damaging your articular cartilage from sports injury to big traumas. Being at the trauma hospital, we're interested in these big car accidents or combat traumas that might be happening. Science really allows you to be inventive in a way that you don't get sometimes in other approaches, because you're really trying to invent something that's never been discovered and a new way to do something. And so I knew the problem I had with that after having all these knee surgeries was that I was going to end up with osteoarthritis, which is where you start to get degradation of cartilage. And right now there's nothing you can do. Your cartilage just degrades, and eventually you'll need a knee replacement. So I was really interested in trying to solve that problem. So come up with something that nobody had used before and solve that problem. And that's what's great about science, is you can have an idea and you can be really creative, and there's no boundaries to your approach and what you can come up with. The biggest obstacle is staying positive through either the failures to get funding, or even in your daily science, you'll get really excited about something, you're convinced it works, then the experiment fails. And that can be really discouraging when you put so much of your heart and energy into, you know, sometimes you maybe spent like 3 really long days in the lab to try to do this experiment and it doesn't work. So those can be really disappointing. So I think the biggest challenge is remaining positive and being okay with the fact that you have to try and try again. I think sports training has been really important to that. Same with any sport, where if you fall, you get back up, you try again, and you're constantly trying to learn and improve. And so that's a challenge, but it's also part of the reward for when it actually works out. Right.